Hello, hello friends and loyal Wolfpack members, Chaos Wolf here, and welcome back to Planet Base. Now, you know what? I thought that I've been doing really well up until now. We've got our colony going, we've got a good amount of metal, we've got a little bit of bioplastics, and everybody seems to be fairly happy and everything's going fairly well. Until I decided to just click randomly on YouTube on another person's Let's Play. He starts jumping down on a planet, making his colony, then he builds his biodome. And goes, you know what? I don't really want to have problems with malnutrition, so let's put these particular plants in here like this, put that plant in there, because then it'll make this recipe. And I sit there and I pause the video and go, wait a minute. Recipes? There's recipes in this game! So, I really didn't know what the hell I was doing. Turns out that... where are we going? I want resources. And I want vegetables and then meal. Meal maker. There we go. Look at this! Full list of recipes. I did not even know this was here. Just goes to show how much of a complete and utter there are no words. There really are no words for this. But it turns out we can actually make a bunch of things, a bunch of different meals, and these meals here, we can even make burgers! Burgers, people! Burgers! I love my burgers. I'm gonna have burgers tonight, I think, actually. But you can make these meals, and when you actually put these combinations of things into the meal maker, it makes these recipes, and these recipes stop your people from getting malnutrition. Oh, that's awesome. I mean, look at this. Malnutrition, a condition that occurs as a result of not eating enough variety of food. It is not deadly, but affected colonists won't be able to work. They can be cured by a medic in the sick bay using medical supplies. That's the thing. That's the killer. It's using all our medical supplies. Ah! Right. Oh, no. That's malnutrition again. Let's have a look at nutrition. This is a measure of how well-fed the colonist is. If it goes too low, health will start to drop and the colonist will eventually die. Colonists usually get fed by eating meals, and the canteen meals are usually made in the meal maker from vegetables and vitro meats. Okay. So... let's go and have a look back in the meal maker. What I'm thinking of doing is putting in some wheat and some mushrooms to make pasta. Because that's what that guy was doing. So it turns out that mushrooms are very low maintenance. And that's something else. That's something else I found out as well. So let's go here. Let's go to the edit. You know, I just thought these different things just meant starches, vegetables, meter impact on connection. Okay. Oh, crap. It's the airlock. Oh, that's just bloody typical. Who we got here? He's idle because he can't get inside. Do we have an engineer inside who can go and fix that? Let's speed this up a minute. Come on, somebody go and fix that door. There we go. We've got somebody going, I think. Yep, yeah, good, good, good. There we go. Perfect. All right. How do I actually stop this from going too quickly now? There we go. Game speed set back to 1. Okay, so let's go back to editing this. Turns out that all these are actually foods, and then they're not just starches. It just means that some of the foods that we do have will produce starches as well. So there we go. Let's have a look. Wheat. Starchy. So let's do that. Let's go and knock off a few of these bloody things. I mean, we don't need the tomatoes. So yes, let's knock the tomatoes off. Let's knock the onions off. Let's knock the lettuce off. Because a lot of these are going to be high maintenance as well, which I've just recently found out. So no wonder our biologists were bloody rushing around like bloody idiots, trying to get everything done. So, yeah, I know we've run out of spares. P-pad, let's get rid of that one. So let's go and put in a bunch of wheat. And let's put in some more mushrooms. So we're gonna have wheat and mushrooms. What we got here? We've got two rice pads and potato pad. You know, I think I might recycle those as well. We've got enough food at the moment. And I'll put some more, because what we got? We got wheat. Wheat is a hydroponic vegetable, starchy. Okay. Now I think I'll just put some rice pads in as well, because those work as well. So there we go. Rice is, it's fast production, high maintenance. Let's actually not put that in yet. So let's undo that one and that one again. So we've got wheat, we've got mushrooms, that'll make pasta. The wheat and the vitro meats will make burgers. So that's great. Now let's just have a look at what else we can make here. So let's go back over here. Let's go back into resources. Let's go into meals, meal maker. So let's see. Tomatoes, lettuce, wheat, mushrooms, pasta, rice, mushrooms, tomato, pasta, rice and beef is pasta, rice, pork is pasta, burgers. We got burgers and pasta, so we should try and make some kind of low maintenance salad, maybe. Lettuce, tomatoes, peas, lettuce, tomato, maize. Because we need to get some more bioplastics made, so we need to go and put some more starchy things in there. So maize is salad, we don't want that. Radishes, onions, maize. Let's just put some more wheat in for now. Let's just get our bioplastics going. So starchy, yep. There we go. So that should be okay. We'll put one more medicinal pad in as well, because then we can actually get some more things here. And look at this. These things are now in good standing because we've got a lot of stuff that is low maintenance. Ah, that's so much better. So now what we can actually do is start optimizing this base a little more. So what we should start seeing is some more starches coming in. So let's speed this up. We've got enough metal, so what we can do is start expanding over here, getting our power production back up again. So I might do that, actually, considering. Might even put another mine in, but I think we've got enough as it is. We've got crap tons of metal, so we don't need to worry about that. But we've got all our wheat, so let's have a look now. Wheat's producing. Yep. Okay, so that's awesome. I know we're out of spares, but we're going to be okay, because we're going to be getting a lot more bioplastics soon. So we've only got a couple of bioplastics. I'm not sure where they are, actually. We haven't got any in there. We haven't got any in here. But we have just made some spares, so that's good. Yeah, we've run out of medical supplies. That's fine. We are making some more. We're actually very close to making some more now. So that's all good. We've got a good amount of medicinal plants. The meat's going down. The meals are going down. But very soon we should start having some good stuff. What I think we'll do then is we'll bring in a landing pad again. What I want to do though... Yes, I know our food stocks are low. We're very close to getting some food properly done. We're very, very close to having a lot of it made. So I think we're going to be okay. So let's see. There we go. Look at that. We've got a bunch of wheat. We should have some meat knocking about. We do, so we can start making burgers. It's too bad I can't set this as a priority. But we have food. We are going to be fine. We have one medical supply at the present moment. People are coming to come over here, make some food. Let's go and see what we're making. Is it working the way we want it to? All wheat. Meal basic. We need to put some... yeah, I definitely need to get a laser in here soon. We need to put some meat in as well. Because at the moment we're just making basic meals. We need to get some meat made as well. So what I think we could do with doing is getting into the lab as well. But we have meals being made. Let's have a look at our vitro meats. They're doing okay. As soon as we get some more meats coming in, let's see. Basic meal. Nope, that's what I wanted to check. Yeah, we've just got a lot of basic meals at the moment, so we do need to get some more meat and stuff. So we got a canteen here. So what I'm thinking is because we've got the vitro meats there. Let's see what we got over here, actually. Nothing there. What we got here? Oh, we got pasta. So look at that. That is awesome. Again, our food stocks are going down, but we are going to be making more food soon. So I think we're going to be okay. All these things, they make vegetables, but they also make starches as well. So that's going to help our bioplastics production as well. But I do think we could do with another biodome now. So I think we've got enough water. Yeah, I know our food stocks are getting low. We have the bioplastics. We have the metals. I'm going to go and put a big, big biodome in, I think. We have vegetables. They're going down, but we need more. Well, let's go and have a look, see how what we can do about those meteors, because I'm getting a bit concerned about those. Telescope, 2 to 4. I think we can afford to put a big one in. Can we put it anywhere? That's fairly close. You know... I think here will be a good thing, because I am planning to knock off those two dorms eventually and replace them with something else. So that's 5 metals. Now, I think we are going to want some more... some more power. So let's put a big... Let's try and put this here. There we go. Perfect. Let's link that up, and I think we are going to want another power collector. So I'll get a power collector. I'm going to put a big, big power collector in here. Can we not fit this over here at all? Oh, we can, we can. There. Perfect. So okay, that'll be enough for now. That'll hopefully, that tell, actually, we also need to build something else here. So that should allow us to see meteors. Well, it should allow us to see solar flares and sandstorms coming a lot sooner. Yes, I know we've run out of medical supplies. What I'm thinking then is I might even sack this one off for the moment because we've got some meals. I might knock this one off and put a bigger one in here. Because I might knock this out and change this. We'll have to see. I think I will drop this one off for the moment. As soon as we've finished building all this, we've just got this one left to build. Just got to have our engineer come out and fix that. And there he goes. As soon as that is built, I am going to go and... Ooh, that sounds close. As soon as that's built, I am going to sack this one off and build a larger place and just have meal makers in and have a smaller one off to the side with just seats in, I think. So, are we finished building? Yes, we are. So, that should be enough power. So, let's disable that for now. Get everybody out. And recycle. Yes, that's going to be a lot of stuff. Let's go build another canteen. And we'll go for a big-ass canteen this time. You know, I think I'll put it down here, off here. Nope, link. There we go. So then we can put something else here. So that'll be a big canteen. We can put a lot of meal makers here. We can put another biodome here as well. And another lab. So we can start sorting out our food production a lot more. So what I might do here actually is recycle this. And recycle this one. Now let's edit. Let's put some water there, and let's put another meal maker in here. And then we can put another water there. There we go, that'll do. That'll suffice. So now all we need is... we're waiting for three resources, but they're all here. So that's fine. People are tired. We got some hungry people as well. So our food is a little low, but we are going to be making... We should... be able to pull through. So I might make this one priority as well. So we're not waiting for anything, we just want the engineer to come out. And then what I'll end up doing is I'll probably end up building a habitation area around here so I can knock this off, put something else here, and just make things a lot more efficient. So here comes our engineer. He is hungry, but we have got a good amount of food at the moment. Let's have a look. So we are making meals. There we go. That's just a basic meal. What's this? Ah, can't see. What's this one? Got pasta and pasta. So that's going to be at least making it so our guys are going to have some decent food. Yeah, I know our food stocks are running low, I know our medical supplies are running low, but I'm going to be fixing this soon. So we're going to be putting in a second biodome. Speaking of which, I think we might need to go for another water collector. Let's go for a big one. Let's connect this over here. Right, so hopefully, we've got a telescope console there. We might want to start bringing in some more colonists soon. And here we go. Time to start putting stuff into the biodome. We have a bunch of things here. Oh, this is a canteen, isn't it? That's right. So let's put 1, 2, 3. Okay, back. Yellow alert. Oh, no, that's not what I meant. So that'll be another three meal makers here. I'm going to put another biodome over here. So let's get this done. We should be able to do a lot more. We can put another storage off somewhere here as well. And maybe we can start putting in some landing pads over this side around the storage. So we can actually make a trade area around here. We've got our water collector, so now we should have no issues with a second biodome. Would be nice if we could get a large-ass biodome, but I think for now we'll carry on. And one of you guys was asking what's up with you? You can't be malnutrition. We've got this stuff here. We just need our engineer to come around and build it. That's what they're doing now. There we go. So that's awesome. What I might want to do is build a connection over between these two. Actually, I can't, can I? Because I can't knock this off. Because we have this here. Because we can't build connections off these two. But oh well. Right, okay. Time to try building another biodome. I mean, we have some bioplastics being made. We have a good amount of starches. I actually might want to put another couple of bioplastic machines in here, actually. We've got a good amount of metal, so we don't need to stress that yet. So as soon as those are built, our bioplastics production should go up fairly quickly. Might want to put another table in here. And just a water fountain. So that's going to be taxing our bioplastics quite a bit. But it'll be worth it so people don't have to sit on the floor and eat over there. Right, I know our food is running low, but we are still very close to making a lot of food. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and make another part, another biodome, make something else. Alright, table's been built. We have 5 things there. I wanted a large biodome, but we need some more materials in order to do that. We're making spares, so that's no stress. As soon as our what I'm thinking now is we'll go and get another biodome, get our food under control, and then as soon as that's done, we can start bringing in some more colonists. So, yeah, okay. How many bioplastics we got? We got 6. Let's see what it'll take to make a biodome. 7, okay. I am liking the position of this, though. I mean, we can wait for the moment because we do have some food. Like I said, the foods are going up and down. We do really need to get some more food in now. So maybe we can sack something off to build more food. What can we sack off, though? Let's sack off the droid thing. We don't need it as yet. We don't have any droids, so let's sack that off. We have enough bioplastics now. Let's build a large biodome. And I will connect it to the lab. So as soon as this is built, we can start putting some more food in. We have 13 bioplastics now. So that will be awesome. So that's our main concern, is fixing our food now. Because people are getting hungry. Again, we are getting close to making some more food. But as soon as this is built, our food production is hopefully going to skyrocket. Because these are all low maintenance. Let's turn this off priority. Yep, we're having no trouble over there at all. Let's turn this off priority. I mean, a little bit of an issue over there, but not a lot. So let's just fill this with some more. Uh-oh, we have lost someone. I think they might have died of starvation. Yep, I thought so. Okay, so we have enough food to put some more things in here. Hydroponic. I want something fast. Fast production, high maintenance. Let's put one salad in. Let's put some potatoes in. Um, Let's put one tomato in, so at least then we can start making some salad. So this should start making food very quickly. Yep, so let's go and get some more starchy things in as well. We've got two bioplastics, so we'll have to wait for a moment, because we're going to need that bioplastic for something else. But people are getting very hungry. I am going to have to put another lab over here somewhere. I think I'll put a lab here. Or even storage here and have a lab off to the side. Let's put this one as priority as well. So let's get our food under control. And there we go, we're actually making some food. Right, what's he coming to do? He's putting that into this one. That's making some basic meal, I think. Basic meal. People are eating, so it is going okay. We have more food in. We have more food being made. We have more bioplastics, so let's go and put some more bioplastic producing stuff in. Fast production, high maintenance. Slow production, low maintenance. Let's put a couple of maize in. So that's maize. That's going to be great for not having to stress about things. The bioplastics are still going up. Let's put some more mushroom pads in as well. Don't know if we're going to have enough to make all that. So let's recycle one or two of them for now. Because at least now this will give us more food. So yeah, our food's going up, our meals are going up. So we shouldn't be worrying about food now. And in here, let's go and make another spares machine. Because the spares are a big concern at the moment, because we haven't got enough bioplastics for it. But now we have got three of these bioplastic machines running. Now people are hungry, but we are making more food. So as soon as everything is fine and dandy, what we're going to do is we're going to make another lab. We're going to make another lab off here, another storage linked to the two. And then another lab. And what we can do then is we can use this lab. Huh? Why have we only got one workbench now? Did I knock one off? I don't remember doing so. Oh, that's what it was. I built another connection there. Okay, right, that's fine. Now I know what's going on. But like I said, we'll build another lab as soon as our bioplastics start getting a bit more under control. Because we've got nothing there. That one's on the process. This one's in the process. So we're doing okay. I can turn off these ones for now. I can turn off priority on this one. So it's just food that is the main concern right now. But we are getting a lot more food being made. I want to build a connection between these two, actually. I think that might be a prudent thing to do. So let's do that. That's going to be a little bit of metal, a little bit of plastic. But what that will enable us to do is take the food directly from there to here. We don't need to go all the way along to here, or all the way around. So that will help optimize everything else as well. But I am thinking I am going to make a habitation area down here. I'm going to knock this one off, I'm going to knock that one off, and I'll build something else in the middle. Not sure yet what I'm going to build there. Yes, I know we've run out of medical supplies. We are making some more, so that's not a big, big stress. Now what we're making here. Again, basic meals. We need to get some more meat in here, really. Otherwise, we're not going to be able to help with the... There we go, look at that, that's awesome. Bioplastics, okay. Alright, well, I think we have enough bioplastics and enough metal now to go and make another lab. Lab. Here we go. Let's make a slightly larger lab. Can we? Yeah, that's the largest lab we can make. Let's link this here. And I'll link it directly to there. I don't need to make a connection there yet. Because what this will allow us to do is we'll put a load of vitro meat machines in here. So we can sack these two off. And then we can put a bunch more meal makers in here, so that's probably a good idea, actually. Meal makers, let's put another two in. Actually, recycle that one, and we'll probably just want some chairs as well. Can we put more than one set? Nah, it's just one thing here. Right, sandstorm imminent. Yellow alert, people. Right, we'll just get this lab built, and I think that'll be enough for this episode. So, again, our food stocks are running fairly low, but I think we will manage to pull through. We do just need to get some more vitro meats being made. Our vegetables are going to be going up, because as we can see here, we have got a lot that is being made. We've got some more wheat being made here. Over here, we're about to get a harvest. So it's no big stress at all. I think we're going to be fine. Get inside, you idiots. Oh, never mind. He still needs to get inside and go to have a rest. He's hungry as well. So we just need this one last connection to be made, where we can then make a bunch of vitro meat machines, and that will allow us to make a bunch of food, which is really what we want. Yes, we've lost one colonist due to starvation. Let's have a look. We're still okay. We're at 21 colonists. We've lost a few. So let's put in some vitro meat machines. So, solar flare imminent. F6, yellow alert, everybody. Get inside. If you're not inside, get inside. I think everybody's inside, so I think we're going to be okay. It's another meal maker, we've got more food incoming. We're running out of medical supplies. We've got the stuff to make them though. So what I'm thinking now is we can, as soon as this one's finished, I am going to sack this one off. So I'll sack this one off already. Okay, so that's the solar flare over. We just want this one to finish. And what would happen if I was to sack this off now? Right, so we do want, as soon as this is all over and done with, we need to get some more people in here so we can start doing some other odds and ends. Let's change that one to beef, actually. Tissue synthesizers. There we go. So all we need now is just to get these over and done with. We can put another thing over here, another storage or something, and that'll be great. Come on, guys. Let's change that one to pork. And that one to stay as whatever it's going to be. So I'm going to put that one as priority. I'm going to turn this one off priority. Oh no, that one needs to be in priority. Does this, is this? Yeah, we're having some real big issues. We definitely need some more biologists in. Okay, but that's enough for this. That's enough for this episode of Planet Base. I do hope you have enjoyed this. If so, please do hit that like button. It really does help my channel out. And if you haven't already, please do hit that big subscribe button to join the Wolf Pack. You'll get notifications from whenever I release new videos. And I will see you very soon. I've been Commander Chaos Wolf, you've been Epic, and I'll see you next time. And remember, keep flying and stay shining.